I'm sorry, sir. She is dead.
And the key.
Where is the key?
There was no key found on her body, sir.
The shroud will be mine, even if I have to raise hellfire to do it.
Burn the letter.
Well, what say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abeline family's robust constitution.
Two pennies robbing the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to seal it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault. Fancy. Fitting for Twopenny's tomb.
Now I'll take you in and you'll see everything is...
Where is Twopenny?
Please! I have a family! He's in the vault ogling his priceless paintings.
Get the bastard! Teach this clot a lesson! Oh!
Where is Tupini?
Please! I have a family. He's in the vault ogling his priceless paintings.
Get the bastard!
Oh, fancy. Fitting for Tupini's tomb.
for your time, good sir. Enjoy the day.
I will let the governor know how helpful you will be when next we come.
Don't harm me. I'll assist you. What would you have me do?
I rather fancy a private tour of the vault.
I'm gonna find you, and when I do, you'll regret it! Life to count it, as long as you live.
All Damn your clumsiness!
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Faster!
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their work.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
We'll be right back.
Where's the police? We're saved!
Arrest them all for robbing the people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice. The currency, a laughing stock. Inflation out of control, twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffooned Israeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however. I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other, when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again! Understood? You may see yourself out.
Dear Mr. Starrick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Starrick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie. Nearly.
Yeah.
What has happened?
Your brother.
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Tupini's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Tupini's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help. Follow me. Spent nearby. Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Avalon.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Avalon.
Down.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
Thank you.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
The counter...
I'm not interested in wasting my time on you. Keep moving.
The counterfeiters.
Heard about the rioting at the bank? They can riot all they like. We won't be giving back those points. What difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on him. Since we've got the printing plates, it's all real cash. Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting. Nothing to do with us.
I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. Yaks in haste.
Trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir.
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
I won't let you muck up my day with this rubbish, understand?
Absolutely, sir.
Now to sneak these back into the bank. There you go. Come on!
She's found herself a nice spot.
Where are you up to then?
I want to be shot.
Right, miss, you're feeling faint.
Come on, miss! Why do you looks familiar.
Never taken.
Well, the London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.
Thank you. I don't see how.
Any goings on?
Hey, boss!
Mrs. Stupid Idiot.
Good work.